Now let us begin with a new topic that we have in front of us, that is differentiability. This is the second topic in which we are going to be dealing, that is differentiability. In continuity and differentiability, this is the second topic. Okay, so as the definition goes, we will discuss this definition, whatever is there on the board, in the later stage. Now what I want to tell you is the real facts of about what is actually differentiability. Now consider you have this much of length or this much of an area, but the requirement for your study is only a smaller area. You know a bigger area, you need a smaller area. In that case, suppose this point is point C, then if the function f of x denote this curve or this area, then if I differentiate like d by dx of f of x at one particular point, and that particular point will be that point C, then this is nothing but differentiation. Okay, so basically I know a bigger value, I want a smaller value. You will take differentiation of the function at a given particular point, that is point C. In that case, this limit definition, so whatever is there on the board, it's time to learn. Now suppose f is a real valued function, C is a point in the domain, then the derivative of f at C, then the derivative of f at C is defined by limit of h tending to 0 f of C plus h minus f of x f of C divided by h. Okay, it's now let us discuss some rules for the derivative. Some rules for derivative we will discuss. Okay, in case of addition and subtraction, there are two rules. Now you suppose mana maine u and v are two different functions, right? And they are separated by plus or minus, and the whole bracket ka agar you are taking differentiation, you are going to take the differentiation of the whole bracket, then it can be written as separate f u cha differentiation pahila, plus or minus after that v ka differentiation. That you can do. So the next thing, this is very very important, product rule. Everyone makes small or big mistakes here itself. Keep this in mind. U v hold as I, you cannot write it as u dash v dash. No, you cannot write it. You have to use this equation where it says u and v is there, take differentiation of the first term, keep second term as it is, change karunuka, plus second function's a derivative and first function as it is. See, I'll repeat, first function ka derivative, second function as it is, second function ka derivative, first function as it is, which are separated by positive sign. Okay, now the third one goes hand in hand, same high. Now you can write it as u by v, this is division rule. U by v ka agar whole differentiation le rahe ho, then u dash v minus v dash u, it matlab kya, first function ka derivative, second function as it is, beech mein negative sign, uske baad mein second function ka derivative, first function as it is, and in the denominator v ka square. Okay, you can, how usually we remember is u by v ka derivative we remember in sentence, like denominator square, first function derivative, second function as it is, minus second function derivative, first function as it is. So this is how we remember actually. Okay, he bhi tasach we remember. So you can, if you want, you can remember in the form of sentences. Okay, so these are the bunch of formulas what are required in order to solve the differentiation, which is pretty much very easy. So d by dx of x is what, 1, so in that same case d by dx of sin x is cos x, and so on. the thing goes on repeating. All formulas are important. I just want you to remember for sine, cos, tan, cosec, sec, cot and inverse of first three. These are very important. Baki ka at least this and all you will understand in the later stage. That is very much easy.